Barnard was a woman of deep and abiding faith, a woman that was attached to her church, the Living Water Christian Center, to the point where it was the centerpiece of her life. She physically took care of the property. She was part of all of the community programming. She went overseas with the church. She stayed and handed out items of clothing. She did eggs on Easter. And the church gave back to her. It was like an extended family. They provided her another job when she lost hers, working at DIR. They provided her a car from Bob Self, one of the other parishioners, to allow her to get along. And it almost seems just unfathomable that that connection to the church would lead her to meet Ronald McLeod, that it would allow a woman capable of such Christian fellowship to have her life taken away by a man such as Ronald McLeod, capable of such profound evil. But that's what happened in this case, Your Honors. On June 4th, 2005, she was doing what she loved, helping to beautify the church, a new church, excited because they were going to have a national chapter come and dedicate and speak and minister. And she wanted it to look nice, so she got her old hedge trimmers, went to fix it up. And instead of taking the kindness that she had bestowed upon the defendant in this case over the previous couple of days and allowing it to benefit him, he chose to use it an opportunity to isolate her, Your Honors, to physically attack her, to savagely rape her, and to brutally strangle her, leaving her dead in the church she so loved, discarding her body like garbage. It's difficult to imagine a more degrading way to be left for your extended family to find you in that bathroom. His DNA underneath her right hand, consistent with struggling with a man scratched on his left side and left shoulder. Her beloved cross and crucifix, even visible, you can turn this on, Dan, in her DIR badge, torn from her body and cast aside, left on a broken trash can. Her hair piece lifted off, the toilet knocked off its mounts. This woman fought. This woman tried to stay alive, but that did not stop the defendant. He continued to cut off her blood supply to the point where he caused massive bleeding inside her neck. And we all saw the pictures of her throat removed and the blood behind the spine and how it existed and how much the pallor and color of her face and head had changed. They prepared a search warrant. They went back to 4707 and they found her bag hidden in his brother's room. They were also able to trace the steps. See, the forensic evidence that the defendant left behind was also great. He had left a palm print on the sink, his right hand, and his left index finger on the sink too, consistent with somebody standing facing the sink in this direction. There were numerous scratches that were noted on his body shortly after the crime would have occurred, when the defendant had walked from the church, had left down Packer from the Chelsea Avenue, and up Camden and run into Mark Ersic, as seen by Jessica Happ. Your Honors, the evidence was submitted to the crime lab, and Jody Ganda identified from the Lorraine Crime Lab, the palm print and the fingerprint. And she did so on June 16th of 2005. The DNA wasn't done until later. Ronald McLeod purposely killed Janet Barnard on June 4th, 2005, as he stood above her body, squeezing on her jugular veins so hard that finger marks were left in her neck and batiki were everywhere until she expired. Count 3, aggravated murder under the A section, it has 3 specifications. It is with prior calculation and design, Ronald McLeod purposely took the life of Janet Barnard. The evidence is great, as he squeezed for those minutes and had an opportunity to stop. He never did. With the design of ending her life, he kept the pressure up so great, causing such grievous harm, that she died.
Insistent that she was hit, knocked down, strangled in the hallway, and her body was dragged into the bathroom. Why is that important? Well, there was a count of kidnapping, two counts of kidnapping, was not checked. It wasn't tested. There was no DNA taken from that or tested against that, against Ronald McLeod.
Count one, receiving stolen property, a violation of revised code 29-1351A, a felony in the fourth degree, guilty. Count two, tampering with evidence, violation of revised code 29-2112A1, a felony in the third degree, guilty. Count three, aggravated murder, in violation of revised code 29-0301A, guilty. The specification thereunder charging the aggravating circumstance of having committed this aggravated murder in the course of a rape, guilty. The specification charging that the offense was committed with a sexual motivation, guilty. The repeat violent offender specification, that is guilty as well. Count four, aggravated murder, in violation of revised code 29-03.01B, guilty. The specification charging the aggravating circumstance of having committed this aggravated murder in the course of a rape, guilty. The specification charging that the offense was committed with a sexual motivation, guilty. The specification charging that the defendant is a repeat violent offender, guilty. Count five, murder, in violation of revised code 29-03.02A, guilty. With respect to the specification charging that the offense was committed with a sexual motivation, guilty. The specification charging that the defendant is a repeat violent offender, guilty. Count seven, felonious assault in violation of revised code 29-03.11, a felony in the second degree, guilty. The specification charging that this felonious assault was committed with a sexual motivation, guilty. With respect to the sex of the specification charging that the defendant is a repeat violent offender, guilty. Count 10, rape, a violation of revised code 29-07.02A2, a felony in the first degree, guilty. With respect to the specification charging that the defendant is a repeat violent offender, guilty. Count 13, kidnapping, a violation of revised code 29-05.01A3, a felony in the first degree, not guilty. Count 14, kidnapping, a violation of revised code 29-05.01A4, a felony in the first degree, not guilty. Count 16, as amended, a violation of revised code 29-03.02B, charging that the murder was, the death was caused in the course of committing a rape, guilty. With respect to the sexual motivation specification thereunder, guilty. With respect to the specification charging that the defendant is a repeat violent offender,